We're joining you from Kota in Rajasthan. One of the most interesting contests in this election will be the battle for Jhalrapatan, where you have sitting Chief Minister Vasundhara Raje, who has been contesting from here since 2003. And on the other, you have the outsider, the man from Barmer, the son of former Union Minister Jaswant Singh, Manvendra Singh. Manvendra Singh is targeting the Rajputs in the area. He wants to attack the BJP style of functioning. He wants to attack Vasundhara Raje and tell the people that this government, the BJP government, has been working selectively with the farmers' community. Take a look at this special interview. We caught up with him earlier in Jhalrapatan. You've been called an outsider here. The BJP says you've been parachuted.
Yeah, I'm a paratrooper by training, so I'm not surprised I'm being accused of being a parachutist. It was a surprise that I received about being considered for this seat. But it's an honor to be considered, and I thought it was too tempting an offer to be refused. And whatever the accusation, makes no difference to me.
What is the key issue that you're raising with people here in Jhalrapatan when you're addressing these sabhas, these gram sabhas? What is the main issue that you're taking to the people?
The main issue is, of course, the nature of governance here in terms of attitude towards people. And I mean, there is a subterranean reign of terror here because of one person. And I was very surprised the other day. I met some sarpanch who had been arrested for wearing black clothes because that was considered to be a mark of protest. So these kind of things keep coming up. I wasn't exposed to these this earlier in the area that I operate in, Barmer or Jodhpur, Jodhpur division. So that was a surprise to me. So the main thing is a reign of fear. And then, of course, there are various local issues in terms of farmers, in terms of teachers. Like this village where we are, there's a huge issue about a fair price for garlic. This is a huge garlic producing area. And they feel very shortchanged because I think they were selling at about 2 rupees a kilo.
But that is the thing, Manvendra, because when we speak to the BJP, they tell us that they bought enough garlic from the farmers despite the losses to them because of demonetization. And these are unnecessary accusations being made by the Congress party. The BJP has, the government has bought produce from the farmers. They've made loan waivers as well, 8,500 crores in loan waiver. They brought in free electricity.
I don't think there's any such thing as free electricity. I've been part of it, so I know about free electricity. And I think loan waivers have been done, but they've been done selectively. And in terms of the fair price for garlic, I think the best answer can be given by the farmers themselves. No point making it into a party issue, because it, if you limit it to just an, a contest between two parties, you won't come to a solution. You ask the farmers and they tell you whether they got a fair price or not, and how many of them got it. If 2 out of 100 farmers in a village get it, and obviously it means that people have been selected on the basis of their connections, and rather than everybody being treated equally, and that's where the main issue is to be treated equally.
Yeah. So farmers' distress will this be your key priority as you fight this election from Jhalrapatan?
It is a major priority here, because unlike Barmer, which I'm used to, farming is the biggest occupation here, and this is a very productive area. As you can see, it's very green, and it's a I think potentially it's a three crop area. I'm sure most of the farms are three crop, and so that's for them is the biggest issue.
Okay, you refer to Barmer a couple of times. Would you have hoped that the Congress should have announced your candidature from Jhalrapatan earlier? Do you think it's a little too late also in the day?
I don't know whether announcing it makes any difference, because I think in any election an element of surprise is always there. And I said to somebody yesterday, I think this is Rahul Gandhi's political strike against Vasundhara Raje. And like a surgical strike, this is a political strike. So when you to strike, you have to keep a surprise. You can't, it can't be launched well in advance and announced well in advance before launch.
But if Manvendra Singh doesn't succeed from here, then what's the road ahead?
The road ahead is as mapped out by God. I'm not distressed by that thought. I'm surprised that I've been selected, and I hope to live up to the expectations of being selected. But I'm not under any distress about what the future holds.
Right. Talking about Jhalrapatan, Vasundhara Raje her son, and BJP leaders say that nobody else can win from this area. There's been a lot of development brought in by Vasundhara Raje. There is a railway line now. There's a railway track. There is a medical college that has opened up. There is a mini secretariat here. Do you think those achievements are going to make it difficult for the Congress here?
No, the achievements have been done. I'm not denying the achievements. I'm not denying that, you know, there's a mini secretariat. But behind the mini secretariat, there are various other things. And it's not on the nature of development of, you know, publicly constructed material that, that people vote. I mean, people vote on sentiment. And they vote because they get fed up of a particular type of governance. And the nature of governance is really the biggest issue in Rajasthan. It's not just limited to Jharkhand. It's across Rajasthan. It's a question of, you know, what style of governance that has been, affected on Rajasthan.
What is the one thing that Manvendra Singh would provide to people of Jharkhand and Jhalawar if elected to power?
The first and the most important thing that I would like to do, and I've done before in Barmer, is to treat everybody equally and not select who's a better or a lesser person. For me, everybody's equal. And that's what I've been doing in Barmer, and that's the message that I'm carrying across here. And it's seeping in. I mean, I'm sure it'll seep in. Of course, to go back to your question earlier, if I had more time, there would be more chance of sweeping it to a larger number of people. I don't have that luxury of time, but I'm making an effort at it.
Right. Talking about independents, do you think they will have a key role to play in this election? I believe the Congress is also having an anxious time with the rebels. And in the last four assembly elections, we've seen the independents securing about 10% of the votes and at least 7 to 10 seats.
It depends on seat to seat. I mean, there's no fixed formula on who affects where. Certainly, there are independents who are influential and they do win seats on the basis of their personalities and their previous record. And some just win by accident who never been known earlier. They just like the right combination on that particular date of polling. 10%, what you mentioned is all across the state. So obviously it's easy to get 10% independent vote when there are 200 seats. And you accumulate all the independent votes from across 200 seats, then 10% is possible. But it doesn't mean that, you know, those 10 independents who won got 10% of the total. It's not that. But I don't think there's a problem today. I think the Congress will definitely win in any case.
The Congress Party's main campaign plank in this election is farmers' distress. But this was completely rejected by Vasundhara Raje's son, Dushyant Singh. We caught up with him in his Lok Sabha constituency of Jhalawar. He said that his mother and Vasundhara Raje has done a lot for the farmer community, including an 8,500 crore loan waiver, free electricity and schemes for women and children. Take a look at this special interview. Would you agree that this is the toughest battle that Vasundhara Raje, your mother, has fought till now?
The party is contesting. Is not the chief minister. She's our leader in our state, and she's been the most prominent person who's transformed Jhalawar and Bara in the Harad region, and also every part of the state. All the 33 districts she's worked very hard at, and all aspects she's worked at, and she's moved the state up and done well for the state. And it's not only her fighting, it's the entire party who's contesting. Okay. And so it is the party contesting, is not her contesting.
But would you also agree that anti-incumbency is going to be a challenge? The party has replaced more than 60 MLAs, 5 sitting ministers have also been dropped. Somewhere the party realized that the sitting MLAs have not found favor with the people.
Mr. Luthra, the party is at surveys. So higher party members who have probably sat down, and the parliament and the parliamentary board has worked on the strategies, which I might not know about, but they've done the best for the state. And each member who's contesting has been given the opportunity to contest. Some people have worked many years. Had not got the opportunity. Now probably they got the opportunity to contest. So it is not only we are working for our party, not for the person.
If we talk about farmers' distress, the Congress has made this the single biggest issue in Rajasthan and all the poll-bound states. In fact, Rahul Gandhi campaigned in Jhalawar. He addressed a rally where he spoke about garlic farmers, about hundreds of farmers committing suicide in the state of Rajasthan. Does this worry you?
I must tell you that the procurement of garlic in state of Rajasthan has been 10,000 metric tons, of which 9,500 metric tons has been procured from Harwati region. Mm-hmm. It's the first time in the MIS scheme is that we've been able to procure so much at 3,200 per quintal. 500 has come from the other part of the state. It's even in Ashok Gehlot's government, they only procured 6.2 crores of garlic. And when Mr. Rahul Gandhi talks about farmers' distress, we want to remind him. He came here to my parliamentary constituency, put a stone in the Parvan water project, and went away. And the stone still exists there. And BJP government came in and transformed the Parvan water project into actual project with financial support to it, with environmental support to it.
Okay.
And so now the work has actually been done. Congress has only lied to the country, and they want to divide people into this. But it's the BJP and our leadership, under the leadership of Prime Minister Modi, and the leadership of our party president Amit Shah, and our chief minister, who has been able to transform our state.
Just to press a bit more on the farmers' issue, the Congress is saying more than 100 farmers have committed suicide. The state figures say only about 5. Who are the people to believe? The Harwati region has seen farmer suicides as well.
I don't agree with you. The state chief minister and the state has done a fabulous job in creating the Mukhyamantri Jal Swalamban Abhiyan, by which the water the table has increased. She's been given given the farmers 10,000 rupees for the rebate in the electricity bills. Farmers have got 50,000 rupees as from a cooperative loan. It's the first time in the history of India that such a loan waiver has been given by any state government, especially when the state exchequer was left in doldrums by the previous government.
Manvendra Singh being brought in, he could make a big dent as far as the Rajput vote is concerned. Will that limit Vasundhara Raje to the Jhalrapatan area? Do you think that this will play on her mind and the BJP's mind to make sure that Jhalrapatan now doesn't go out of their hands?
I must tell you, Ms. Lutra, that my mother, who's our chief minister also, she's worked hard for the entire district of Jhalawar and Bara. Firstly, Mr. Manvendra Singh has been given an opportunity by the Congress, and he is coming in from all the way from Barmer. So he's never worked here, but there's no, my mother is also comes, my grandmother was also from a Kshatriya community, and so she also a Thakur. So that issue of yours which you were talking about does not work out, because she believes in all communities. We don't only believe in one community. We love all communities, and we work with 36 communities which is here.
So he's being parachuted.
I certainly believe that when Mr. Gandhi was here a few weeks ago, and he mentioned on stage that he will not put a parachute candidate in any of the 200 constituencies. But the fact of the matter is that Mr. Gandhi has given a ticket to a person who's been parachuted from a district, and there's no local candidate who's been given the opportunity to contest against the honorable chief minister.
Time for a short break. On the other side, Archana Shukla will join you with all the ground reports from battleground Madhya Pradesh. But before that, take a look at this report from Jaipur's Jauhari Bazaar, where traders are upset with GST and demonetization. And they also told CNBC TV18 that business is down by at least 40 to 45%. Take a look.
Jauhari Bazaar in the heart of Jaipur is the Pink City's biggest market. It's crowded and full of colour, it is popular among the residents of Jaipur and tourists for gold and silver jewellery, clothes, handicrafts and mouth-watering Rajasthani delicacies. Traders call it the economic lifeline of Jaipur, but ahead of elections, they are worried about the market sentiment. Jewelers here say that the 3% GST rate and demonetization has turned customers away and has forced smaller traders to reduce staff as well.
अभी इलेक्शन में सबसे बड़ा मुद्दा होगा जीएसटी का, क्योंकि इससे व्यापार पे काफी असर पड़ा है. जो सेल थी वो काफी डाउन गई है.
सेल कम से कम भी 40 से 45% सेल हर मार्केट में, हर फील्ड में कम है.
कम है
हाँ. और जीएसटी का बहुत बड़ा एक ये क्या है, देश को पीछे जाने का एक मेन कारण मानते हैं हम लोग.
मेन कारण तो अभी जो मार्केट पे असर आया है वो डीमोनेटाइजेशन और उसके हाथों हाथ आने जीएसटी के कारण ही है. व्यापारों के लिए बहुत बुरा है, पर देश के लिए ओवरऑल अगर देश की बात करी जाए तो बहुत बढ़िया है इसके लिए.
But Kailash Chand, the head of Jewelers Association, feels that rather than GST, it is demonetization and the state and the center's policies towards small traders that has affected business.
डीमोनेटाइजेशन, नोटबंदी एक बहुत बड़ा मुद्दा है, क्योंकि सरकार की एक हम इसको बहुत बड़ी गलती मानते हैं. जब से नोटबंदी हुई थी उसके बाद से लेके व्यापार पे बहुत बड़ा इफेक्ट पड़ा है. नहीं देखो, इसमें वसुंधरा सरकार ने कोई पॉलिसी नहीं बनाई, ना केंद्र सरकार ने कोई पॉलिसी बनाई. केंद्र सरकार द्वारा खाली एक पॉलिसी दी, बड़ी जो ब्रांडेड कंपनियाँ हैं, बड़ी मल्टीनेशनल कंपनियाँ हैं, उनके ऊपर सरकार का ध्यान फोकस रहा. मीडियम क्लास व्यापारी का बिल्कुल सरकार का ध्यान नहीं रहा.
We also visited Jaipur's most famous eatery, the 290-year-old Lakshmi Mishtan Bhandar, to speak to the owner and the president of the Jewelry Bazaar Market Association, Ajay Agarwal. He too agrees that Diwali sales were disappointing and emphasized that the market desperately needs better infrastructure.
After demonetization and since last four years, both the state government and central government have not put in their best of efforts for generating new employments and creating new jobs. I think that is a major problem. There's nothing drastic to be required. It is like redoing all the things which have already been done, like the sewerage systems. They have already lived their life for 200 years. So they are now to be re-restored and repaired and make good. Another last for another 150 years, whatever they want. Same is for the parking structure, parking places. Same is for the normal, if you just don't see the main market, you have to, if you go by the by lanes and gullies of all the markets, you will feel that a lot of encroachment is there, a lot of filth is there. Swachh Bharat Abhiyan has rightly been taken, and I think it would be more serve more purpose if more toilets, public urinals would have been created under the Sulabh complex schemes and all.
Traders here are unanimous in their view that the market sentiment is far from upbeat. GST demonetization, according to them, will be issues in this election. They are also feeling neglected by BJP at the centre and the state, saying not enough has been done for small traders. They also demand better infrastructure, saying while there has been development under Vasudha Raje, the city is still far from becoming a smart city. With video journalist Lakshman Singh from the Jewelry Bazaar in Jaipur, this is Parikshit Luthra.
Well, a visit to villages in Mandsaur, the villages that had participated in the farmers' protest last year, reflects the anger that farmers still have as far as agricultural policies of the government are concerned. But it also brings a big trend and a focus on the increased politics around farmers' protest and how every single political party in the region is trying to gain mileage out of that. We visited some of these villages to understand if the lives of the protesting farmers and their families have really changed and if that anger has somewhere subsided. Otherwise quiet villages that bear witness to one of the fiercest farmer protests of recent times. And the increased politics around it. Families families of farmers who lost their lives in the protest are still unsure of their future despite government's compensation and promise of job.
सरकार की तरफ से आपको मुआवजा मिला था उससे आपके घर खर्च उसके आपका कुछ निकल रहा है उससे काम
अभी तक उसमें से कुछ नहीं किया
उसमें से आपने कुछ लिया नहीं है
नहीं लिया मैं तो जाती भी नहीं हूँ
अभी क्या कर सकती है सरकार आपके लिए
आप बताओ
Most others are wary of any assurances and are reluctant.
Silot Pipaliya village, an unfortunate village that lost one of its farmers during the protest last year in Mandsaur, in Pipaliya Mandi, where the farmers were protesting for their rights. Behind me is the statue that the local administration has built in remembrance of the farmer who had lost his life during the protest. One protest which somewhere had brought to fore the anger of the farmers here in Madhya Pradesh. आपके जीवन में कुछ बदला है पिछले एक सालों में?
बदला क्या और नीचे जा रहा है किसान तो बदलने की बात अलग बात है मोदी जी कह रहे हैं कि 2022 तक किसान की आय दुगनी कर देंगे हाँ ये जरूर है कि किसान की मृत्यु दर दुगनी कर देंगे वो
पिछले साल जो आंदोलन हुआ था उसमें आप सब लोग गए थे
सारा गाँव गए
सारे लोग आप लोग सब गए थे आपको लगता है आप लोगों ने जिस तरह से आंदोलन किया उसका कुछ भी निष्कर्ष निकला है कुछ भी उसका आपको
निष्कर्ष तो कुछ नहीं निकला सिर्फ ये भावांतर योजना किसानों पे जबरी से थोप दी जबकि इससे किसानों को घाटा ही है फायदा नहीं है
आपके गांव में और आसपास इस इलाके में किसानों को लेके बहुत राजनीति भी हुई है आपको लगता है राजनीति में कुछ फायदा किसान का हो रहा है
किसानों के नाम से ही वो सब राजनीति कर रहे हैं बीजेपी वाले ज्यादा कर रहे हैं इसमें और कुछ नहीं है
अब हम सब बढ़ चुके हैं अब हम जातिवाद में कोई पाटीदार कोई ठाकुर कोई हरिजन इस तरह से हम बढ़ चुके हैं कोई पार्टीवाद हो गया है अरे ये तो कांग्रेसियों ने किया था अरे नहीं ये तो बीजेपी वालों ने किया था इस तरह से हम इस गाँव में बढ़ चुके हैं सब गाँवों में जहाँ जहाँ से ये शहीद हुए थे और जहाँ जब हम आंदोलन किया था तो सब लोग अब बढ़ चुके हैं
किसान किसान नहीं जातिवाद
जातिवाद में बढ़ चुका है पार्टीवाद में बढ़ चुका है यहाँ पर ऐसी धारणाएं बन चुकी है कि इन्होंने आंदोलन किया था ये कांग्रेसी हो गए अब वो बीजेपी वाले हो गए वो पाटीदार हो गए ये ठाकुर हो गए वो हरिजन हो गए हम सब इस तरह से बढ़ गए बस ये फायदा हुआ है और इससे राजनेताओं को फायदा हुआ है
अब उनको
हम नहीं मान रहे हैं नेता है लोग मान रहे हैं क्योंकि उनको अब पता चल चुका है कि ये वोट इतने अपने हो गए हैं ये अपने हो गए हैं हम लोगों को तो उन्होंने हम किसान सब भाई हैं हमको अलग कर दिया उन्होंने
एकजुट होके उस टाइम पे किसी ने ये नहीं सोचा कि मैं बीजेपी का हूँ मैं कांग्रेस का हूँ मैं पाटीदार हूँ मैं ठाकुर हूँ मैं या एसटीसी हूँ कुछ भी सभी किसान एक साथ गाँव से निकले और रोड पे गए
इस बार जब आप वोट करने जाएंगे तो क्या सोच कर वोट करने जाएंगे
इस बार वोट करने तो मतलब जो हमारा फायदा करेगा पहले जो कांग्रेस सरकार ने अच्छा फायदा दिया था हमें
जुमलेबाजों की सरकार पे हम कैसे विश्वास करें
आप लोग को लगता है कि आप लोग फिर से आंदोलन करने जाएंगे अगर आपकी बात कि अब आप लोग को डर लगता है किसी चीज से
यही स्थिति रही और अगर कुछ भी सुधार नहीं हुआ तो हम एक बार फिर अपने सब साथियों के साथ वापिस इसी तरह से जाएंगे और अगर फिर प्रशासन ने यही हरकत की तो इससे भी बड़ा हो रहा आंदोलन हम मरने से नहीं डरेंगे और नहीं पीछे हटने से डरेंगे
अगर किसान आंदोलन नहीं करेगा तो या तो घर पर बैठ के आत्महत्या करेगा इससे अच्छा तो हम लड़के मरे
सारे नेता कहते हैं जय जवान जय किसान तो जवान के साथ अगर वो दीपावली मना सकते हैं तो किसानों के साथ क्यों नहीं मना सकते और नहीं भी मना सकते हैं तो किसानों को दीपावली मनाने तो दें कम से कम अपने भाषणों में किसानों का जिक्र तो करें
मर जवान मर किसान ये मोदी जी का नारा ये हो गया अब